Okay, so we have seen how, with the aid of row reduction and back substitution, we can find the solution for a set of equations if it exists, right? Or if whether it exists and when it exists, what the solution is. All of this can be obtained with the aid of row reduction, right? If when you have a set of equations which is, which gives you a square matrix, right? When you have a, the number of equations is equal to the number of unknowns. In that case, there is an elegant, way of obtaining the solution using something called the Cramer's rule, using determinants, which uses determinants, right? So that's the subject matter of this lecture. Okay, let's start with a 2 by 2 system of equations, right? So I have a1x plus b1y is equal to c1, and then a2x plus b2y equal to c2, right? The solution is, of course, easy to obtain. X is equal to, this c1 b2 minus c2 b1 divided by a1 b2 minus a2 b1, and y is a1 c2 minus a2 c1 divided by a1 b2 minus a2 b1, right? So notice that the denominator of both, the expression for x and y involves a1 b2 minus a2 b1, right? So this is actually nothing but the determinant of your coefficient matrix, right? So in fact, you can rewrite this solution in a compact way, which lends itself to generalization to n linear equations in n variables. So x is determinant of, right? So you form this coefficient matrix a1 a2 b1 b2, and you put that in the denominator and find its determinant, right? But if you are interested in finding x, so in place of, a1 and a2, which are the coefficients corresponding to x, so whichever variable you're interested in, you implant, the right-hand side, the coefficients c1 and c2 in place of the coefficients for, c1 and c2 in place of a1 and a2 comes in here, right? So this is what, so we have here, right? You have to compare between the matrices in the numerator and the denominator. So the only thing that is different between the numerator and the denominator is in place of a1, a2, you have c1, c2. And likewise, in place of a1, a2 here, I have, so in place of b1, b2 here, I have c1, c2, right? So wherever you have, coefficients corresponding to a certain variable that you're interested in, those coefficients have to be omitted, and in place, you bring in the constants from the right-hand side here, right? This is the prescription, and this works for, n linear equations in n variables. I have shown you for 2 by 2 explicitly, but this form extends, right? So I'm not going to write down explicitly the general form. You can work this out. So let me just state this again, right? So this is what is called the Cramer's rule. So the key point is that you must look at the determinant of the coefficients, right? The co determinant of the coefficient matrix is also called the determinant of the coefficients. So only if this determinant D is not equal to zero, this Cramer's rule holds, right? So that's when you have a unique solution, right? So this is actually a criterion for whether a system of n linear equations in n variables has a unique solution, right? If there is a unique solution, this Cramer's rule can give it to you, right? Now, if the determinant is zero, then, you have to be careful and go about studying it, separately. So that can be the subject of a later lecture, which will follow. But let's look at what happens when D is not equal to zero here. Then you have the Cramer's rule. So to end this lecture, I'm going to give you one example, right? How this can be, exploited, and then in conjunction with the properties of determinants that you have already seen. So let's look at this, apparently complicated looking set of equations, but it gives us a 3 by 3 matrix. So let me just pull out, these coefficients. So let me first write down. So here the goal is to find z. So I have a minus b. Let me write this down. I have a minus b minus a minus b. Then I have 3b squared. 3b squared. And likewise, I have a plus 2b. A plus 2b minus a plus 2b, and then I have minus 3ab plus 3b squared, minus 3ab plus 3b squared with the brackets covering both terms. And then I have b a and b a and minus 2b squared plus a squared, minus 2b squared. So I need to find this determinant, and then I also need to find another determinant. So this I can call it delta. I also need to find this other determinant. Okay, let me try, let me compute this. So the key observation that I make here is, you know, I have a minus b, I have minus a minus b, I have a plus 2b and minus a plus 2b. So whenever I see something like this, the immediate suggestion that I have is to subtract the second column from the first column, or to add the two. If I add the two, then I'm going to get zeros, right? So zeros are good things to have when you're evaluating determinants. So if I add the second column to the first column, so I have zero, I have zero, then I have a plus b, then I have minus a minus b, minus a plus 2b, then I have 3b squared, minus 3ab plus 3b squared, then I have a, then I have minus 2b squared plus a squared. So actually these last two quantities don't even matter. So I see that if I go along the first column and I just have this one term, it's just a plus b times the product of these two minus the product of these two, so which will give me, I can pull out, so I can, let me write this as a minus b, the minus sign cancels, a minus b times 3b times a, 3b times a plus b. Then I have a minus, there's a minus sign, so that becomes plus 3b squared times a plus 2b, so which is a plus b times 3b times a squared minus b squared plus ab plus 2b squared. So my answer is 3 times a plus b times b into a squared plus ab plus b squared. So the other determinant that I need to evaluate is, so to get the answer for z, it's going to be, so this determinant I'll have to find. So a minus b, so in fact the first two columns are the same, so I will do exactly the same transformation, which is to add, you know, the first column and the second column. So I might as well write this as 0, 0, a plus b, and then this will be minus a minus b, this will be minus of a plus 2b, and I have a, and only the third column changes, and the third column is 3ab, 3b squared and 0, 3ab, 3b squared, and 0. I need to evaluate this determinant. So once again, this is just equal to a plus b. So I have to find the determinant of this 2 by 2 matrix. There are these two minus signs which are sticking out, so which I can actually pull out. So I have a plus b, overall minus sign I will pull out. So then I have 3b squared into a minus b minus 3ab into a plus 2b, right? So which is equal to, so again I can pull out 3b, and so in fact I also have a minus sign, so I have 3b into a plus b into a squared plus 2ab. So the second term becomes positive and the first term is negative. So minus 3, I have pulled out a 3b. So I have a minus ab plus b square. So which is equal to 3b into a plus b into a squared plus ab plus b squared. So we have all these nice simplifications, and so the answer is z is equal to 1. Very simple final answer, right? It looked like a mess, but there is a way to get to the final answer using determinants, using the Cramer's rule. So that was just an example to illustrate how this may play out in a real setup. That's all for this lecture. Thank you.